So if you're wondering about these two fragrances, the Olympia and the Olympea Aqua, just stay tuned. First, we have Paco Rabbane's Olympea, which was released in 2015. And I do believe this is the first fragrance of the Olympea line. And you guys, this bottle is stunning. Look at this bottle. As far as the scent go, you guys, if you got Paco Rabbane Olympea, you already know about this one. This is definitely a salty vanilla. That is all I pick up in this scent, is a salty vanilla. It kind of takes me back to my childhood. And I lived in New York City. I lived on Governor's Island, because my mom's husband at the time, he was in the Coast Guard, and it was a base called Governor's Island, and I lived on an island in NYC, right in Manhattan, you guys. If you are a New York girl, you know what I'm talking about. I lived in New York from second grade through fifth grade. When I first smelled this, this is what that took me back to, because in the winter time, there was like a bordering fence around the island. The water would be so rough. The water would just like splash up against that wall. We called it the seawall. But we would walk around the railing of the seawall, and then the water would just like splash up on there, and all you could smell is salt. This really reminds me of that water and how it smelled, because it was so salty and it just smelled salty. So this is a very nostalgic fragrance for me. That's why I absolutely love this scent, and I have been getting some good use out of her. But I can't say right now, you guys, this is a beast. All I get is salt and vanilla. It has other notes, but all those other notes are irrelevant when it comes to this scent to me. And this is a very good scent. I'm gonna let y'all know if this is better than the flanker, which is the Olympea Aqua. So here we are with the Aqua, and this bottle is really, really stunning as well. But all of the glass is like frosted, even the top is frosted. This is an eau de toilette, and this original Olympea is an eau de parfum. So that is the first difference between these two, is that this flanker is an eau de toilette. Also, that you have a frosted glass. But I can say about this scent, this is more citrusy, definitely more citrusy. It still has the original Olympea DNA to it, but this totally changes with citrus. So it is similar, but it's also very different with the citrus. The bergamot in this stands out. Like, as soon as you spray this and smell this, you definitely pick up that citrus, you guys. You get a blast of citrus right after you spray this. It's also a lot fresher. This is more on the fresher end. The original Olympea is too strong and heavy for you, but you do enjoy the scent. I would definitely say go for the Aqua, because it is fresher, it's lighter, it doesn't last as long, but you still get that crisp, salty smell. It's still salty, baby. This is still salty. We're not going to get away from the salt. Paco Rabanne was not playing with the salt notes in this Aqua and in the original. And then there's another fragrance that is salty that I just reviewed, y'all. That shit was nasty, okay? Like, and I apologize. I apologize to anybody that loves that Bulgari Aqua Divina. That was salty, but that was nasty salty. That was way too grandma-ish, per se. This right here, the saltiness is well-balanced, but you still definitely smell the salt and vanilla in this. You had that citrusy opening. So this is a very, very nice scent. It is a mature scent, and it does not last as long as the original, but it's definitely a contender, y'all. So with the big question, like, which is better, with me being a perfume connoisseur, for my opinion on which one of these is better, this is more bomb to me. And only I think it's because of the nostalgic reasons of this one. This is lighter, it is very pretty, and more floral. This is more floral, so I would definitely say that I do like the original better, but baby, she's staying in my collection because she's still nice. And also, this I would not wear in the summertime. This is too heavy with vanilla. I don't wear anything that's a heavy floral or vanilla scent in the summertime because it doesn't do well with the heat. But she is a definitely fall, good fall and winter scent. And as you can see, I've been wearing her. I love this. And I haven't even had this that long, and I've been spraying this. So as far as the Olympea Aqua, this is perfect for spring and some parts of summer, because this plays more on the florals, and this is more fresher. It's more aquatic. So this is definitely a fresher one. I would definitely wear this more in the spring and summer, and I would definitely wear this original more in the fall and winter, and this more in the spring and summer. So both of these are must-haves in your collection. If you love the original, I would definitely say try to get your hands on the Aqua, because it is worth it if you love Paco Rabanne's Olympia line. And also, you guys, they do have a So Intense. I don't have that one. I'm looking for it. I would love to smell it, but I don't know even if I smell it if I will purchase it, because this right here is intense enough for me. So I can only imagine the intense version, because this right here is intense. So I'm definitely itching to smell it. I want to smell it, but I don't know if I would pick it up. I guess I would have to see. And they do have another Aqua that just came out not too long ago, you guys. Olympia, this Olympia line is not playing, okay? So there is a total of 5 in the Olympia line right now, and I definitely want to smell the new Aqua just to see, because Paco Rabanne makes such gorgeous fragrances. They are a little more on the mature side, but they are such powerhouse fragrances, and I absolutely love them. And you can find these two for really, really good prices. I don't know if this is available. I know this is available on fragrancenet.com. I don't know if the Aqua is available on fragrancenet.com, but if it is, I will leave a link down below. For those of you who are a little weary about Amazon, I have ordered several times off Amazon. I never had a problem. I will only put up links that's actual links to the actual designer. It's not like a drop ship or anything like that, because I am a little afraid of those. But the links that I post, those are more reputable. So I would say, you know, if you feel more safer with FragranceNet, I would try to leave a link of whichever one is cheaper for you guys down below. So definitely check these out if you have not checked these out, and try and smell these, because these are powerhouse fragrances that I absolutely adore. But I definitely want to give props to Paco Rabanne for these two fragrances. And there's another one I want to try, is the Lady Million. I do want to smell Lady Million again, because I have actually smelled Lady Million before, but it was so long ago, and when I smelled it, it didn't appeal to me in that way, because I would have bought it if I really liked it. So I'm definitely going to want to try out Lady Million. And if I'm not mistaken, they do have a Lady Million Lucky as well. I will have to definitely look and check and see, you guys, because I'm trying. It's hard to keep up with all the new fragrance releases and all the new fragrances, because there are so many coming out. But I'm definitely going to look that up, and you definitely will see it here on this channel if I pick it up. So that does conclude my take on Olympia versus Olympia Aqua. I hope you guys enjoy the video. And if you did, please be sure to give me a thumbs up for this video, and also subscribe if you have not already subscribed, and also be sure to share my video on other platforms. I really appreciate that, and I hope you guys have a beautiful day.